Dear children, the narrator says that no sensible man would buy a diamond by the dim light from a tramp. Tramp means beggar, because there is a chance of cheating. He again says that the diamond of that size would cost many thousands of pounds, but the stranger asked only 100 pounds from the narrator. The narrator asked him from where he got it. He replied that he made it himself. The narrator had heard something of Moissan. Moissan, who was he? A French chemist and Nobel Prize winner. He attempted to make synthetic diamond. But the narrator knew that his artificial diamonds were very small. The stranger understood that the narrator knew something about diamonds. So the stranger became ready to tell something about himself. The stranger turned round with his back to the river and put his hands in his pocket. And he said the narrator would not believe him. Then the stranger explained how to make diamonds. He explained that diamonds are to be made by throwing carbon out of combination in a suitable flux. Flux means a chemical mixture and under a suitable pressure. Then carbon crystallizes out not as black lead or charcoal powder but as small diamonds. He explained the chemical works to the narrator. Now the narrator became surprised. He was talking like an educated man. He continued his talking. He explained that the diamonds made by chemists are small and dark, worthless as jewels, because the chemist did not find out how to have the right pressure for the best result. Dear children, the stranger says that he spent his life for making pure diamond. He spent many years for that. He has given his life to it. I began to work at the condition of diamond making when I was 17, and now I am 32. That means he spent these many years in making pure diamond. One has to work hard for years. If one succeeds, the hard work can get you millions. And if one succeeds in making good diamond, pure diamond, then he will be able to earn millions. He paused and looked for sympathy. Two things, said he, that I was about to make millions, and look at me now. The stranger looked at the narrator for getting sympathy, and the stranger worked hard many years for earning millions, and look at him now. What was his condition? He was looked like a tramp. Tramp means beggar. I heard he went down about 1,000 pounds when I was 21. I worked as a teacher. I felt that with the money I earned, I would continue my research. I studied for a year or two in Berlin. The trouble was the secrecy. You see, if someone got to know what I was doing, they might have profited. If I really wanted to make a lot of money, it was important that people should not know that one can make diamonds by an artificial process. So I had to work all alone. At first, I had a little laboratory, but as my money began to run out, I had to conduct my experiments in a poor, unfurnished room in Kentish town, where I slept on a straw mattress on the floor among all my apparatus. The money simply flowed away. I did not spend on anything except scientific equipment. I tried to earn by a little teaching, but I am not a very good teacher and I don't have a university degree. I do not have much education except in chemistry. I found I was spending a lot of time and energy for little money, but I got nearer and nearer my goal. 3 years ago, I solved the problem of the composition of the flux and got near the pressure by putting this flux of mine and certain carbon mixture into a closed up gun barrel, filling it up with water, sealing it tightly, and then heating it. He paused. Rather risky, said I. Yes, it burst and smashed all my windows and a lot of my apparatus, but I got a kind of diamond powder nevertheless. Then I came across the work of Dobry. Dear children, the stranger started to tell his story to the narrator. In the beginning, he worked as a teacher and he earned some money. With that money, he continued his research. He studied for a year or two in Berlin. The problem he faced was the secrecy. If someone got to know what he was doing, they might have profited. Means, if you want to make money by making artificial diamond, you have to keep that process, you have to do that process in a secret way. Otherwise, everybody will know about it. So, the stranger had to work all alone. He could not appoint anyone for his help. In the beginning, he had a little laboratory for doing his research. But later, he had to give up that laboratory because he did not have money to give for rent. So, he had conducted his experiments in a poor, unfurnished room in Kentish Town. Dear children, poor fellow, he slept on a straw mattress on the floor among all his apparatus. He did not have a bedroom for sleeping. He slept with all his apparatus. Do you know what is this apparatus? Apparatus means equipment. Then he tried to earn by little teaching, but he was not a very good teacher. And he did not have a university degree also. Without a university degree, nobody would appoint him as a teacher. But he was good in chemistry. He found that he was spending a lot of time and energy for little money. But he got nearer and nearer to his goal. What was his goal? To make artificial diamond. 3 years ago, he solved the problem of the composition of the flux and got near the pressure by putting this flux of mine, and a certain carbon mixture into a closed up gun barrel, filling it with water, sealing it tightly, and then heating it. This portion explains the procedure, how to make artificial diamond. He paused means he stopped. Then the narrator told it was a risky task. The stranger agreed. What happened? It burst and smashed all his windows and a lot of his apparatus. But dear children, he got a kind of diamond powder from it.